Okay, we're here with Norm Semanko. Norm, tell us why you're here today.
Well, we've got a little conference here in Whitefish, Montana. We're talking about lands and water issues and federal control and how folks can have better control locally. That's what it's all about.
You're one of the speakers here today, right?
Yeah, they asked me to come talk about water rights issues and specifically what we're doing in Idaho with the water rights adjudication and fighting back on all the federal claims to our water that have been filed. So I'm going to share with them the experiences we've had, how we've tried to be successful, and maybe what's going to happen here in the future. So just going to share some information.
How is that fight going?
Well, it's going really well. We have an argument in the Idaho Supreme Court coming up early November, and all of the federal claims have been filed on behalf of the Portland Tribe are going to be an issue. We had a decision by the district court that was mostly favorable that the court is going to hear. Appealed by the tribe and by the United States, and then on some of the issues that he didn't rule favorably, we appealed, and the state of Idaho appealed. So there's actually four separate appeals that are going to be heard over 2 days, early in November, and then we'll get some decisions, and we'll know where things stand.
You're also working on the Avista Hydro 1 deal, aren't you?
Yeah, I've been asked by a group of Avista customers, called the Avista Customer Group, to look at the proposed merger between Hydro One out of Toronto, Canada, and Avista, of course, our local utility in Spokane. And we've identified some issues and some concerns, so we've raised those to the Idaho Public Utilities Commission. There's going to be a hearing November 26th on that. And, of course, it's all about trying to make sure that we don't see excessive increases in rates. And, with a corporation that's out of Toronto that's almost majority-owned, over 45%, I believe, by the province of Ontario, and what impacts that can have on Avista customers. So a lot of questions to be answered, and hopefully the hearing will provide some clarity and we'll get a good decision out of the PUC.
Where is the hearing going to be held?
It'll be in Boise at the Public Utilities Commission headquarters. I understand they might try to video stream it or at least audio stream it, so check the Idaho Public Utility Commission website, see if they get that set up.
Is this a hearing where a large public footprint would be beneficial?
You know, it's probably not. It's an evidentiary hearing where the Public Utilities Commission will hear from the applicants from Hydro One and Avista, our group, others, mostly talking about what the potential impacts are going to be. So it's very evidentiary at this point. It's not they've already had large public meetings, as you know, throughout North Idaho and heard that testimony. And in fact, that's one of the reasons, probably the primary reason, why this hearing is being held, is because there was so much public comment. So, no, I don't think it's that kind of hearing.
Okay.
Folks certainly can attend. Encourage people, if it's streamed, to watch it online and keep informed of what's going on.
Well, if it's being streamed, Redoubt News will pick it up and share it for everybody.
Wonderful.
There's 5 states that have to approve this deal, right?
Yes. Avista has service in 5 different states.
Okay.
Idaho and Washington are the 2 with the most service. Neither of those states has approved it yet.
Okay.
Oregon hasn't approved it yet. Montana has just a very few customers, and they did approve it with some conditions. And then Alaska just has basically the city of Juneau, as I understand it, through a small company that Avista bought years ago, and Alaska's approved it. So the 3 major states still have yet to approve the merger.
Okay. And we're just hoping that they don't. Is that right?
Well, until we get good answers about what it's going to do to rates and how the province of Ontario is going to be able to control or not control Avista and impact rates, absolutely, we're opposing the merger at this point. So that's what the hearing process is all about. The PUC has to approve it before it can go forward. And to approve it, they have to find that it's in the public interest, and they have to find that the merger is not going to result in rate increases for Avista customers. And in our view, neither of those things has been proven yet.
Well, we really appreciate you taking the time with us today.
Absolutely.
Maybe we'll be able to catch up with you again after your talk and see how everything went.
Anytime.
Thank you, Norm.
You bet.